birth is generally straightforward. But for some mothers and babies, things can suddenly get more complicated. At least one baby each day in the UK alone dies or is injured due to something going wrong or not being picked up in labor. To prevent these tragedies, it's essential to find ways to protect the health of mother and baby. So how do we do that? I am Professor Antoniya Georgieva from the NAFIL Department of Women's and Reproductive Health. My team is developing technology to better monitor babies during the birthing process. It is very difficult to assess a baby's health while they are still inside the womb. Currently, if we want to know how the baby is doing during labor, we use a belt monitor, also known as a cardiotachograph or CTG. It records the baby's heartbeat and looks at how it responds to the mother's contractions. But the results from the CTG don't take into account other important factors, for example, the baby's age or the mother's temperature or if the mom's got preeclampsia or diabetes. Also, the CTG result can be misinterpreted when staff are busy or just can't visually identify that there is a problem from the graph alone. And then they may miss what's really going on. Sadly, if there is an emergency and the baby isn't delivered in time, it can lead to brain damage, lifelong disability, or the death of that baby even. We want to help midwives and doctors to stop the consequences of difficult births and reduce the number of interventions, for example, a caesarean section, when those are not really needed because the baby is actually coping all right. So how does our research fit in? With a team of specialists from different disciplines, we've been developing the Fit4Labour tool. Its software uses algorithms taking the information from over 100,000 births. The data included the baby's heartbeat on a digital CTG, data about the mother's and baby's health and risk factors, along with information about the outcome at birth. Having learned from this past data, the Fit4Labour tool now can help us more accurately predict how well a particular baby is likely to cope with the contractions. The app provides midwives and doctors with a portable tool that's easy to use on labor wards, helping to support decision-making by the medical team and the family. This can both reduce unnecessary interventions, so midwives and doctors are not intervening in labors that are going physiologically well, and it can also help protect mother and baby. Knowing that the baby isn't doing very well means we can deliver them more quickly. The Fit4Labour tool is currently being tested, and we hope that insights from it will help improve the healthcare for pregnant women, all birthing people and their babies. For more information, please visit the Oxford Labour Monitoring website.